Drop shadows and inner shadows simulate light falling on objects, adding 3D depth for a more realistic appearance. Drop shadows can appear behind or below objects. Inner shadows appear inside objects. You can add drop shadows and inner shadows to most objects or groups of objects, including text and bitmaps. Drop shadows and inner shadows can be added interactively or by using presets. After you add a shadow, you can edit it. For example, you could adjust attributes such as color, opacity, offset, and feathering. You can edit shadows interactively by using the vector control or by using controls on the property bar. Drop shadows and extrusions created in CorelDRAW are ideal for printed outputs, but are not appropriate for output to devices such as vinyl cutters and plotters. Cuttable shadows are needed for such projects. To add a cuttable shadow to an object, you must use either a block shadow or by duplicating the original object, filling it with a darker color and placing this behind the original object. To manually add a drop shadow, select the drop shadow tool from the toolbox and drag from the center of an object. To add a drop shadow with perspective, drag from the object's edge. With the drop shadow tool and the object still selected, edit the shadow using any of the following controls on the property bar to specify the shadow attributes. You can change the shadow color by dragging a color from the palette to the shadow handle. Merge mode. To choose how the color of the shadow blends with the color of the underlying object, select a merge mode. The default merge mode multiply produces natural-looking shadows. To adjust the opacity of the shadow, use the transparency slider bar. To sharpen or soften the edges of the shadow, adjust the shadow feathering. Use the feathering direction settings to soften the shadow's edges towards the inside of the shadow, the outside of the shadow, or in both directions. Shadows look more realistic when they use Gaussian blur feathering, which is the default option. Note, the inside and average options are not available for inner shadows. The feather edge setting allows you to choose a feathering type. This control is not available for Gaussian blur feathering. Shadow offset changes the distance between the shadow and the object's edge. With drop shadows, changing the offset makes the object appear closer or further away from the background. To edit a perspective drop shadow, use any of the following controls. To set the direction of the drop shadow, adjust the shadow angle. To set the length of the drop shadow, adjust the shadow stretch. Shadow fade adjusts the fading of the drop shadow. Note, these controls are not available for inner shadows and flat drop shadows. Custom settings can be saved as presets. Just click the Add Preset button and give your preset a name. Presets can also be deleted from the preset list box by clicking Delete Preset. To add an inner shadow, with the shadow tool selected, click on the Inner Shadow tool and drag from the center of the object until the inner shadow is the size you need. The closer to the edge you drag the end handle, the narrower the inner shadow becomes. To offset the inner shadow, drag beyond the edges and the bounding box of the object. You can also add a shadow by choosing a preset from the preset list box on the property bar. To separate a drop or inner shadow from an object, using the pick tool, select the shadow and do one of the following. Click Object, Break Drop Shadow Apart. Or click Object, Break Inner Shadow Apart. Click a blank space in the drawing window to deselect the object and the shadow, and then drag the shadow. You can use this procedure to apply both an inner shadow and a drop shadow to an object. For example, you can apply a drop shadow to an object. Break the drop shadow apart. And then apply an inner shadow to the object. To remove a drop shadow or an inner shadow, select an object's shadow. Then click Object, Clear Shadow. You can also remove a shadow from an object by selecting the shadow and clicking Clear Shadow on the property bar. Note, shadows cannot be added to linked groups such as blended objects, contoured objects, beveled objects, extruded objects, objects created with the artistic media tool, or other shadows. You can't add shadows either to a bitmap, which has been shaped by an envelope, or to objects that have bitmap effects applied to them. You can apply only one shadow to an object, a drop shadow or an inner shadow, not both. However, you can use grouping to apply both shadows to the same object. For example, you can apply an inner shadow to an object, create a group from that object, and then apply a drop shadow to the group.